This is Julia Meling for Hollywood TV, and I'm here with Michael, Cera, and Sebastian Silva for their new film, Crystal Fairy. All right, so tell me about your screenplay. How is it? Is it a true story? Is that based on a real road trip?
Yeah, it's based on a real story. It happened 12 years ago. It's really exactly like the movie. Writing the screenplay was not really a screenplay, it was more of an outline. And it was just remembering every single event and like what was meaningful of every little event that took place on that past experience. And then shaping it into like a good story, you know? Like, of course there's stuff that it's made up, you know, just to help the narrative.
The film also talks about drugs. Did you ever experiment with drugs in your life, or are you in favor of experimenting with drugs?
Kids, listen. No, I mean, I'm not in favor of drugs like that. I would never have a flag that says, like, take drugs, you know? But yeah, I mean, we were like...
A t-shirt,
I would. Yeah, but I mean, like, we were establishing the difference between drugs. It's like, drugs are like people. They're not all the same. You know, like, there's bad people and good people. I mean, like, no. Yeah. Yes, there is. But yeah, with drugs, it's the same. I mean, you have crack that would, like, ruin your entire life, or you could have a DMT that it could give you, like, a very sort of religious enlightenment and, like, change your life and, like, get you out of an addiction, you know?
Did you ever try the magic cactus, or would you try a cactus in your life?
We did try it on this movie.
We tried it, yeah.
And there was no effect.
Yeah, I mean, think it was my fault.
There was no hallucinogenic effect. I didn't feel it at all. And it didn't have any effect on my life.
But we were also very excited. I got the real thing, and I cooked it as you should. And then they took it, and yeah, it felt like drinking rosé or something, like just like a little cup of wine. And like, but Gabby was pretty high. She took a double dosage. She was very impatient.
And we haven't spoken to her in months. We don't know quite where she is right now.
Yeah, Gabby.
Or if she's okay.
One last question. In the nude scenes, you know, with Crystal Fairy, did you ever feel uncomfortable shooting that? Or do you think that some girls are too forward that could turn off guys?
I think, what do you mean, like her comfort with her nudity?
Yeah.
I think that if that situation was happening, it would be uncomfortable. I mean, and if you're not used to it, you know, it's just, there's a naked person, it's just not usual. But they
were... Yeah, and like you're sitting in a bed and you're like pussy level too?
Yeah, pussy level.
It's just like right next to you, it's like right there. Yeah, it was...
It's hard to, I mean, yeah, like that's what the scene is about, I guess, is that could never be...
Yeah, I think it's like, and it also talks to you like how like silly we are about genitals in general,
yeah.
Right? Like, how could you get so uncomfortable with a vagina?
But you would never not notice if there was someone naked in the room.
Right.
yeah.
But shooting those scenes wasn't uncomfortable. Gabby's amazing. Like, she's so comfortable with her body.
I think that
doesn't
makes
hesitate
it,
at all.
Yeah, that makes it really comfortable for everybody. If she was like kind of freaking out or like just being
shy
about
be
it and like asking us to hurry up that she's naked, it would make it really uncomfortable. But she is really cool with it. I envy that. I wish I could be naked right now.